I mean, don't some of your patients find it unsettling that you know so much about them and they don't know anything about you?
Do you?
Yeah.
Why?
Well, for all intents and purposes, you're a stranger. I mean, no one knows all this stuff about me.
For all intents and purposes is used to talk about a situation that, although is not exactly true or accurate, it is almost completely same as it were true or accurate.
So what's the deal with you? Why the bike?
What do you mean?
Well, you don't really strike me as the environmental hippie type.
I was in a car accident not too long ago, and it was pretty bad.
If someone or something strikes you as something, the situation causes you to form a particular opinion or feeling about them.
How's it going? Getting back to the swing of things?
Think so, yeah.
Yeah.
If you get back to the swing of things, you begin to enjoy and get comfortable with a situation or doing a regular activity.
Let me help.
My meds are starting to kick in, so I'm going to try to get some sleep, okay?
If something kicks in, they start to have an effect. For example, when medicine kicks in, you notice they start to take effect in your body.
Here. He's blaming you for the death of his son.
If something is way over someone's head, it would be too much of a concern for them to handle.
Javier.
Excuse me?
The contractor's been doing some work over at the house. We had a bit of a falling out.
If you have a falling out with someone, you argue or disagree with them, that results ending of relationship or long period of not talking with that person.
Something's not right. I was up by the pool the other day, and I could swear he was watching me. And then I caught him eavesdropping on Kate and I. And last night I heard a noise outside the bathroom window. And when I went to look, someone had knocked a pot over. And then to top it off, I caught him coming out of your office today. Something's not right.
Top it off is used in conversation before describing the last positive or negative incident which the speaker would like to rate it as the best or worst that happened.
Good night.
Remember what I taught you.
Buenas noches.
You're going to get an A on that test. Mark my words. Oh.
If someone tells you to mark their words, they are going to make an important prediction about the future that you should remember.
I think I'll call it a night, Mrs. Chase. I'll see you tomorrow.
Okay. Thank you, Javier.
If you call it a night, you stop what you have been doing for the remainder of the night and leave.
We've already spent so much on the house already.
All right, well, maybe we don't need to reinvent the wheel. Let's just have everything that has been started finished.
Yeah.
I'll ask around.
If you reinvent the wheel, you have spent an unnecessary amount of time and effort to start making something that had already been created or optimized by others.
Why don't you the tables while you're here? Tell you what, first 100K's on me.
I'll take a rain check on that.
Anytime.
Rain check refers to an offer, request, or invitation that was initially declined, with the hope or promise that it can be postponed to a later date or time.
Figure out that you're keeping me alive so you can double-cross your boss.
Double-cross? Is that what you think this is?
When someone is double-crossed, it means that a friend, business partner, etc. betrayed them in an activity which they had planned to do it together to obtain joint benefits.
You screwed up.
Joshua, I know, but that...
Let me finish. You screwed up, but you screwed up for the right reasons. You're going to make mistakes, but it's how you deal with those mistakes that's going to make the difference.
So, does this mean I'm not fired?
You're not that lucky.
If a situation is screwed up, it has been spoiled or badly managed as a result of someone's big mistake.
We wait until dark, then we go in.
We? Hey, look, I think I should do this myself.
Why?
Why? Because this mission is a cakewalk. I go in, I get her out, I'm back before anyone knows she's even gone.
No mission's a cakewalk, and I'm not sure you're ready.
Well, there's only one way to find out, right?
Cakewalk refers to an easy task, and is originated from a dance developed from dance contests, performed by African Americans, with a cake awarded as the prize, held in the mid-19th century.
Who are you? Shh. Look, I'm getting a little sick and tired of being yanked around like this. I've got some questions and I want some answers. I told you
If you yank someone around, you waste their time by being intentionally vague, misleading, or taking advantage of them. When you talk someone into something, you are persuading them to do something by talking to them.
Reverend, I'll tell you what, come over to the counter and I'll sort you out.
I'm afraid Mummy and Daddy and Aunt Edith are all away, so you must make do with Granny and Donk.
Authorities plan to ramp up wastewater monitoring program. Ramp up refers to a sharp increase in activity or in the amount of something.
Hi, Mom.
Hey,
hey
there. Chief, out of uniform today. What's up?
Sorry to barge in on you like this right here at supper time.
Get you something, Fran, a beer if you're not on duty?
No, Ben, that's okay, thanks.
When someone barges in, they enter a place in a rush, and usually in a rude way without being invited.
Did they really implant something into your cells?
No, they did.
How'd you get it out?
First, I stopped taking that poison. I weaned myself off. Then, I fasted for about a month to purge the rest of it.
If you wean someone off something, you make them gradually stop doing or using something that they like and have become used to, which is bad for them, for example, a drug or a bad habit.
Where's my manners? I'm yapping your ears off in the doorway. Who is this lovely little lady you have with you?
I'm Clover. It's a pleasure to meet you.
If you yap someone's ears off, you keep talking until your listener or listeners become tired of listening to you.
So I always had a different respect for you, man. You know that, right? I look up to you. Might not be much, but...
If you look up to someone, you show them respect and admiration.
Those were American soldiers you killed.
for no other reason except you wanted to and you thought you could get away with it. Now keep your mouth shut or your teeth won't make the rest of this trip.
If someone gets away with something, they escape blame or punishment or other bad consequences for their bad or risky actions.
Daniel and Maggie, weren't they going out before?
I don't know. Why are you asking me?
Well, you know the real scoop on everything that goes on around here, no?
Don't believe everything you hear.
If someone knows the scoop, they have discovered current and interesting information about something that others may be curious to know about.
Hello? Yeah, we got a new employee here. I want you to take him around and show him the ropes.
If you show someone the ropes, you teach them how to do something, especially a job or a skill.
Should have listened to me. I made a call.
No,
Mike, that wasn't a call. That was a reaction.
You're a hothead, bro. Always have been.
If someone is a hothead or hot-headed, they are quick to get angry or violent.
From rainforests to mountaintops to sun-baked deserts, they've got what it takes to survive in the most severe and extreme environments.
If someone has all the needed qualities to do something successfully, they have what it takes to do that thing.
For that phase, just get ready to be 40 with an empty house because they all abandon you.
Tell me about it. I mean, what happened to
when someone says tell me about it, they mean to agree and sympathize with you as they experienced the same thing in the past.